Now this is the enthralling part of the fight where I just beat the shit out of this guy. We're back, and we are finishing the level up after going horrendously over time of what I intended. I was hoping to keep most episodes to like maybe like 30, 37 minutes, 40 minutes, and I just got into it, and you know that's a good sign for a game. But we've got the level up option on expose weakness here, which removes all exploits from a target to decrease the target's dodge, parry, and armor. Plus 10 exploit attacks times personage. Perception bonus. Okay, so I could put expose weakness on, or I could put the first level, which is that one. I can't pull it up. That puts 4 stacks on, and then it gives you. So it's a good way to deal with high agility characters. Terrific. Argenta, tell me there's a way for you to blow more stuff up. Revel in Slaughter. The soldier immediately removes the winded effect until the end of combat. Soldier gains ballistics, plus 5, plus 2 times agility bonus, critical damage, and agility bonus, critical chance. The ability becomes available after the soldier kills 3 enemies, and the kill counter is not reset between rounds. Okay. So she's just a fiend, is what you're telling me. Now, I am not only dealing with the powers of chaos, but further cramp in my leg. So let me rotate my fat body into a way where I'm not making things progressively worse for myself. Okay.
Look, they say a little bit of humility never hurts anyone.
Oh, shit.
I help others better themselves by wholeheartedly humiliating them at every step.
Alright. Okay, weird flex, dude. I don't know if you guys can hear that particularly well. Oh, I don't like the look of this. Was that just Valencius just striding through that shit? The roar of the flames rings in your ear, and the choking smoke makes you cough and gasp for air. You instinctively recoil from the scorching heat, wiping your face. A moment later, a hazy silhouette forms in the raging wall of fire. You are surrounded by ear-splitting noise and screaming, yet you distinctly hear the sound of footsteps. And then you see the figure walk out the fire towards you. It's Theodore von Valencius. Her expression is calm, terrifyingly so for someone whose body is engulfed in an inferno. One of her hands is resting on the hilt of her power sword, and the other is raised to an inviting gesture. Are you lost, my heir? Argenta goes still as a statue and then slowly raises her weapon. An apparition. A sorceress apparition. Trickery of the warp. Sister, will you lower your weapon? Despite his commanding tone, Abelard does not sound too confident. He is staring at the road trader and you notice a muscle in his cheek twitching. Threatening the Lord Captain is outrageous. How did you get here? I'm Rogue Trader, Boren. I am whatever my will demands me to be. Would you prefer me to be elsewhere at this time? Indubitably, but are you ready? Theodora watches you without blinking. Her snake-like gaze almost makes you forget. Forgot to put the timer on for my recording. Always makes you forget about the fire searing around you, leaving burns on your skin. I can lead you out of these flames, Boren. Show you a path, rid you of pain, give you a weapon so that you may defeat your enemies. Decide. Your mouth begins to salivate. Each word Theodora speaks is like music to your ears. The entity that now dwells in the deepest recesses of your mind is pleading, begging, demanding that you give her an immediate answer, and that answer will be nothing other than acceptance. Do not listen to this abomination, Boren. If there is naught but his light in your heart, if you are resolute in your faith, then step into the flames. The Emperor protects. His faith will not be deterred by either darkness or deceitful purposes, or promises, nor will the fire burn those who carry the torch of faith in their soul.
to the void with you. We need to follow Lady Theodora before we suffocate in this furnace.
The people.
Abelard looks about, coughing and confused, the people around you.
Bori, the survivors from the middle decks. We must help the crew. Lead them out and find a way around.
Over the roaring flames you hear distant sounds, frightened voices and screams, muffled and distorted as if there was a body of water between you and them. Convictions. You sometimes have to make tough convictions that would develop three directions. Dogmatic, iconoclast, and heretical. Well, we're not going to do one of them, because I am a noble commissar. So I've got the options of dogmatic, walk through the fire, the emperor will guide me. Heretical, take my pain away, give me power. And iconoclast, get the people off the bridge, I will not leave my people in harm's way. Ha. Huh. Okay. So I feel as a commissar, it's my duty to lead and devote to the emperor's light. So it's pretty much, I could be dogmatic, just go straight through. You know what, I am a devout man of the Imperium, and I'm not too scared. I sometimes might not shy away from the fact that some people are going to die in this line of work.
The Emperor will guide the righteous on their path.
Thousands of needles pierce your consciousness, but are powerless to stop you. Dogmatic, plus 15. You take a step forward and the illusion breaks. A wave of excruciating pain crashes over you, and Theodora's voice fades into the firestorm. I worried I was going to take loads of damage, and I was just willing to do that. As I got a bunch of medipacks from the loot room. The requisition room, which I legally entered. You hear the voices of your companions calling from behind, and the screams of the weak dying in the inescapable blaze.
Get the fuck out of here.
Oh, sorry lads. The blinding inferno and harrowing pyre and the all-consuming storm releases you as you step out, barely able to stay on your feet. The blood is pounding in your ears and drowning out the world around you. Your eyes, caked in soot and burnt eyelashes, refuse to open. Free from the flames, you take two more steps before collapsing to your knees. Oops. The rush of blood in your temples and horrible pain all over your scorched body cloud your mind. Before suddenly retreating as if driven away by some mighty will, a new strength spreads through your veins, and despite the wounds, your body is ready once more for trials and struggle. You open your eyes and see a globe with warm light before you, the Aquila, the sacred symbol of the Imperium. Let's fucking go. In the next moment, you are struck with another realization, the repulsive presence, the one that has plagued your mind since Volkia wounded you. It's gone. The fire seems to have burned the entity away without a trace.
Master, can you hear me? Oh, you're alive. Which is more than I was expecting after what you just did.
Praise the Emperor! We passed through the flames! How can this be anything but a portent? For so it is said, that the Emperor will bless the worthiest and most steadfast in their faith.
I don't like how surprised she is. She was the one that told me to walk through. And she's like, I can't believe you did that. You damn son of a bitch, you did it.
You son of a bitch.
Behind Argenta, you see Idra Chlass doubled over in a fit of nausea. The rest of the people who are following you have withered away in the fire that continues to rage a mere two steps away from you. Got the Emperor Protect sent shell. Did you see that? The Aquila, it was glowing. We're still alive. Fancy that. I feel like I've got a bit assassin in me. So, we're still alive. Fancy that.
Your attempts at humor are inappropriate. You nearly got us all killed.
Well, you know how it is, homie.
What happened to Lady Theodora? Did she follow us?
There was no Theodora, witch. There was an illusion, a temptation, a foul taint that tried to lead us astray. But he perceived its true nature.
Yeah, you're right.
Is that right, Adepta Sanctimonious?
What? We'll just pretend like we didn't see the Lord Captain standing there in the fire? Abelard, you tell her!
Whatever it was, it matters no longer. Ugh, your conduct is bordering on madness, or holiness. A path opened behind you, where one moment there was fire, the next only smoldering embers remain. But what am I saying? My eyes must have deceived me. Too much smoke for my lungs. Truly, would you have received wounds like these if there had been no fire?
He's got a point.
The wounds are merely a sign of a trial laudably passed. It is something to be proud of, the same as decorations or badges of honor.
All right, we got rise and stand tall, no element holds the power, dismiss the help and stand on my own, and allow Abelard to help you up. Our commissar would definitely do this. So, no element holds power over the righteous. Even if you are anticipating another wave, it does not come. Your muscles feel strong and your limbs obey you without fail. And yet deep inside, next to your heart and stomach, you feel a certain tension, akin to that of a taut string. You are at your limit. Be it adrenaline or strength of your faith, it will not carry you much further. Well, that's not good. Oh, Edelfrad. Edelfrad von Valentia stares at you without trying to hide his astonishment and trepidation.
Boy, did my eyes deceive me? I could swear I... pillar of fire with the rest of you following in your wake.
Alright, we're hurried to join force with the others. It was the only way. And I loathe being... Oh, yeah. I love being late for an engagement.
Nothing good ever comes close as it comes to such rashness. Yet it appears that the Emperor fades you.
Edelfrad examines you once more.
Be that as it may, your wounds are highly worrying.
Oh, shit. He actually, So I've got an 85% chance on this warp test. And we got my faith keeps me upright. I can fight, and they are certainly ugly. I'd rather sit for now. Okay. I'm gonna go for the test here. Succeeded. Edelfrad does not seem to have changed since you first met, but only at first glance. His face has taken on a strange hue. The skin on its temples appears scaled, and his voice now seems an uncanny, screeching quality. See, I predicted that with my interpretation of Edelfrad. These are not traces of fatigue and stress. The psychic's body has begun to mutate, a consequence of contact with the warp.
So you're not in best shape yourself, Edelfrad?
The psychic grins back at you.
Notice the signs of my blessing, have you, Borin? Yes, the warp is taking its toll. But I'm still sane and able to hold my weapon. I will fight with the von Valencia's bloodline to the end. And if the price is the internal curse of mutation, then so be it.
It's like, my faith will keep me upright with a weapon in my hand. That's all that matters.
Edelfrad holds up a placating gesture.
Pray forgive my insistence, but I shall not be the one to doubt the faith of those who have passed a trial by fire. I have gathered everyone who answered the vox call and was able to hold a weapon, yet I do not see the Lord Captain or the Arch-Militant in our midst.
I'll cut back on the stuttering.
We are receiving messages in her voice, but she is not responding to direct requests. I saw the Lady Theodora on the observation platform. When did you and she part ways?
It was the very elevator, Master Ethelfred. The Lord Captain, accompanied by the Arch-Militant, headed for her chambers to retrieve an item of particular import. After that, we all heard from her with vox broadcasts.
Time is inopportune. I am still receiving fragmentary reports from the bridge. Conrad Voidgear was spotted there, and even what scant intelligence of his activities reminds me of the descriptions of sorcerous rituals. If that traitor has resorted to witchcraft, we must stop it at once.
So that I can go to Theodora's chambers to find her, I am ready for the assault on the bridge. I think we got to find Theodora first.
I shall go to Theodora's chambers to find her.
A reasonable approach. Take your escort with you. You may be waylaid,
Once you have found the Lord Captain, you must beg her to go to the bridge and lead the counterattack. The rogue trader's appearance is sure to fill the defenders' hearts with hope, however frightening or exhausted they may be. And until we meet again, Morin, may the Emperor bless your deeds, and I shall see you on the field of battle.
Edelfred salutes you. You know what? I feel bad about talking such relentless shit about Edelfred. He's actually kind of coming through here. Right, let's go to Sweet Home Alabama.
I'll lay claim to the stars.
And her room. Is this it here? Maybe.
Halt! I noticed something.
Oh. Oh, a secret entrance. Obviously, priority. Steal.
It's about time.
Lord Captain's quarters. Oh, straight. Oh, he's got a little secret entrance, you little devil, you Avalard. You little saucy little spicy doodle. So we've not heard any broadcast from her. I've already sort of... I'm a bit sussy that she hasn't met the Sentinel. But I don't know if I'm just overthinking things there. I probably am. But I feel like when we go to the bridge, we're going to find Edelfred dead. Or he's going to be turned into a monster or some shit. Like, I think whatever I chose there, it wasn't going to go well. I will honour Edelfred. There'll be a time when, if he does die, I will avenge him. As a true noble warrior of the Imperium. Oh, look at this. Oh, very nice.
I won't tolerate weakness.
Is this where you've been hanging out, Mr. Avalard? Nice little chamber, look at that. Oh, disco ball at the top. Uh-oh. Oh, double. Uh-oh. Her ballsack hair. Oh, no. Firstly, rob this guy. Very important. I like the way you can see my priorities when investigating what appears to be some kind of murder. Ah, yes. Let us claim this. The murder scene looks like someone caught one of the victims. Theodora von Valensis' body is scrawled on the large, blood-drenched desk. The arch-militant's corpse, still clutching a weapon, is slunked against one of the bulkheads.
Emperor, accept thy faithful souls. No! I... Lord Captain, I didn't hear a thing. Not a whisper, not a breath. It was so loud! Why didn't I foresee this?
Lord Captain. Who would even dare? Unless that rat, Voidsphere.
So almost certainly, or I doubt if I could wish humiliation suffering, or say nothing. I feel like I'm going to say nothing here. I feel like I'm going to keep my cards close.
How could Mort have failed her so terribly? The Arch-Militant was born on a death world. He had lightning-fast reflexes.
I can look at things in my own way. If you find something that might bear the imprint of the killer, just give it to me, and I'll try to see what secrets it holds.
Unless Mort was the one that tried to do her in. Let's see Theodora's body first. You lean closer to the body. The cause of death is apparent. What ended the rogue trader's life was an auto-shot pistol, an extraordinarily accurate one at that. Theodora's face bears an expression of surprise. Okay, it's not looking good for old Morty there. Oh, jeez! I shot Von Valencia! Something on the floor catches your eye. A heap of blood-splattered parchment and scrolls that must have fallen off the desk. As you lean down for a closer look, you notice something else. A small shard of glass scattered on the floor.
Alright, let's inspect first. Let's check the shards. It's difficult to say what was broken. The objects fell on the floor, and that is much as you can ascertain. Upon closer examination, the shard appear iridescent rather than completely transparent, as if they'd been submerged in promethium. Oh, okay, so promethium's kind of like their version of gasoline. I feel like she was trying to burn something. Let's look at the papers. Reports, accounts, dispatches. You go over all the scrolls until you stumble upon a document that is startlingly different from the rest. It is handwritten and signed with the initials X and C, and a seal with a symbol that is vaguely familiar to you, and sends a shiver down your spine. The author of this letter is addressed to Von Valancius, signed it with the seal of one of the holy orders of the Emperor's Inquisition, the secret police of the Imperium that relentlessly hunts heretics, Xenos, and the other enemies of humanity. Oh shit, okay. Examine the Arch-Militant's body. I think it was him. But who killed him then? An auto-pistol shot went straight through Mort's forehead, spraying the floor and the furniture around with blood, brain matter, and shards of his skull. The safety of the Arch-Militant's weapon is off. The killer must have been a split second quicker than he. Okay, let's ask about the shards first.
I see streaks of color, luminescence, blue lights, faces drawing closer. Lady Theodora and Conrad and... what is that? Something dark. Enormous. Oh, this glass thing was something foul. That's for sure.
Maybe it's something she definitely shouldn't have had, and that the Inquisition were having a little sneaky looky look. The Inquisition, if you're wondering, are so far beyond any police or military power that we have on Earth. They're basically second to that of the Emperor in terms of their structure, because they were in the final days before the Emperor was interned on his golden throne. The creation of the Inquisition was made to combat the threats of chaos and the Xenos and the warp in general, and they have pretty much total authority over who they talk to, unless it's another Inquisition member, or like even Astartes, like the Space Marines. They won't like it, but they pretty much have to follow the orders of the Inquisition. So one could just turn up one day and be like, "I'm requisitioning your entire your entire chapter," and you'll be like, "No," and they'll be like, "Well, here's the seal," and they're like, "Oh shit, you're right, okay." So this is not looking good for Von Valancius, and she said that she was going to wherever she's going now for a reason. Something happened between her and Cumrag, so there is a conspiracy afoul.
Tainted witchcraft.
Said Adira, would you try touching Theodora? I tried, but she appears to be related to me.
FBI, open up!
You might be able to see the killer through her eyes.
It doesn't work like that. I can try to read the memories of objects, but dead bodies are a different story. Something like that would require her soul. And after what we saw on the officer's deck, I won't risk searching for it in the warp.
Oh, so when they killed her, they might have used her soul to try and tempt you. Okay.
We'd best be on our way.
Yes, the crucible of battle calls to me once more.
Right, take it down a notch, Argenta.
No, wait! We must see if we can find anything!
Idira, you can't bring her back. Let her go.
You'd give up so easily, old man? I expected as much from the sister. It's not like she has a heart. But you?
Oh, no. I'll get to the bottom of this. I'll find the one responsible for murdering the Lord Captain. And when I do, that scum will regret the day they were born.
Well, I agree with her in the fact that we should keep looking around her place for stuff to steal. What the fuck is that?
Feel my wrath!
I'll turn you into corpse starch.
Is that a battle servitor? Combat servitor. Now, how are they getting here, though? Unless this connects to the bridge. And we just kind of went through a secret way. Alright, let's get the boys up here. Argenta. Go here. Adira, you will be using your psychic powers immediately, so don't think you're getting out of this one. And I'm going to put Borin over here. Looks good. Light and medium armor. Light medium armor both available to you at the moment. And at dodge, higher the dodge penalty, the lower the chance of dodge an enemy attack. Okay. Characters in light armor dodges attacks more often, but you take more damage when hit, and then, you know, you can figure out the rest. Right, so we've got our new abilities here. So I'm actually going to immediately yeet myself into the enemy. As I think it will be cool. Do I go straight for the big bad? I don't know. I can hit this guy. Let's just take a guy out straight away. Nice. And then brace for impact. Because he's gonna take some pops. Do I go with Endure? Or, yeah, I do. He's going to be tiny. He's got like a little mini shield as well. Borin. Okay. Okay, so I'm going to hit Voice of Command. I'm going to hit it on Argenta. And I'm also going to, at all costs,
already
hit myself
done.
With that. Now I'm going to shoot at this guy. I kind of want it to not kill him, because I want to test out the way that this ability works. Enemy for the end of the turn. Let's just stick this on Argenta.
Not a problem for me.
Let's just see how this goes. Now it's Argenta's turn. I could pop this now. Run over here. And I'm gonna hit him with the fucking the quad spray. And can I do that again? Apparently not. I'm gonna hit some momentum. I'm assuming that means that's the how far you can go with distances. So that was not the best time to use that. Oh, so I actually gave that ability to her. Oh, okay. And now she goes. Right, she's gonna do it again.
Yeah.
Maybe it didn't let me do the run and done because it wasn't strictly her turn, so to speak. We are going to fly you up here. We're going to hit you on this. I'm pretty sure this guy's not going to dodge anything. But I just want to try out. It's going to use up the stacks. Make it harder for him to dodge. And I'm going to absolutely scorch the entire team. And Abelard. I'm sure he won't mind. I'm sure it's fine. Alright, please don't shoot Adira. Yeah, don't worry about it. And I'm going to get straight in here with the charge. Let's go. Hit him with that. Come up with the chain attack. Hit him again. Do I need to do... Is there any reason to not do that? No. And I'm going to pull me up to do the incredible voice of command.
Not my specialty.
Not on me. Let's stick it on Argenta again. Oh, I can't. Stick on her. Now, I believe if I just tag this guy... It doesn't. rapid arm. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I'm getting it. I'm slowly getting there. I'm going to give the ability again to Abelard, just to let him throw some haymakers here, and I might be able to finish him off straight up.
Exemplary strike.
And we'll let that roll. Let that roll. Do I have to be in? Can I shoot if I'm in melee? Yes, and he's not gonna hit me. Awesome. And let's go for the ear piercing screech. So I don't kill everyone. Hell yeah. Let's do this.
We must act.
Steal everything. You know the drill.
A new challenge for me.
Let's have a little snoop around here. Oh yeah, not too focused on yourself there, Miss Alabama. Let's do a quick level up and see how it goes. Obviously, again, we're not having too much options here unless we have a talent. Finest Hour. Officer grants an ally an extra turn with full AP and MP during the next turn attack. During the extra turn, there is no attack limit. Awesome. Ooh, and I get a talent. So I got all of the ones that... okay, we got some choices here. Jesus Christ. So it's got ones that it suggests. I'm going to go through them. Officer's Resolve. A range of the officer's ability. That might be quite useful. Blood of the Martyrs. Focus. When officer uses an ability on an ally, that ally gains a bonus to perception, perception and ballistic skill. That will be good in terms of giving people my buff. Temporary wounds. Whenever the officer targets an ally with an action or ability, Della's resolve is increased. Okay. So there's a lot here. Okay. Half the bonus granted by the voice command remains till the end of combat. This bonus does not stack itself or with the bonus granted by voice command, but does count as an offer ability effect for the purpose of other talent effects. Okay. There's a lot here. Okay. Whenever an officer makes an attack, they gain +5 fellowship. That would be good. Whenever an officer uses an officer ability archetype, two times in one turn, that does not grant an extra turn. They gain a stand witness effect. Stand witness, the next officer archetype ability does. Okay. Ooh, that might be good. Will also affect the officer, so when I give them... well, like I say, if I put the buff on someone else, I get it as well. That could be quite good. But then you've got all of these... all of these down here. Seize the initiative, undaunted, and chain weapon expert. Oh goodness. Nimble. Okay, let's see. I do have to dual combat, but maybe not. There's a lot here. Just having the simple straight boost seems pretty strong as well. But I also get to look through this list next time as well. So I'm wondering, because these are abilities from our good friend Argenta. These are Hive World stuff as well. Okay, I'm actually going to go with... I kind of like that lead from example one. It's not specifically marked here, but I feel like having that extra boost on me as well is pretty good. They gain the stand witness effect. The next officer archetype ability that does not grant extra time will also affect the officer. I may be reading that wrong, so I'm kind of tentatively dancing around here. You know, I'm going to do it. Let's do it. Might be terrible. We'll find out. We're gonna fly through these ones. So they're gonna have all their own stuff as well. Oh, bloody hell. So contempt whenever an enemy attacks the. We'll tell you what. We'll stick to for now. We'll stick to the ones that it suggests, just for the, just for the pure purposes of viewer engagement. So I don't go reading through. But I'll probably have a look through off screen for the next ones. So contempt. Whenever an enemy attacks the warrior's next melee attack against the enemy deals additional 5 plus damage. It does not stack, but it can be reactivated after another attack is made by the same enemy or a different one. Okay. If the warrior has less than 50% wounds, they gain 5 plus toughness, bonus versus agility, critical hit chance. Epicenter of Slaughter. Whenever the warrior is attacked, they gain 1 stack of Epicenter of Slaughter till the end of the turn. At the start of the next turn, the warrior gains 1 temporary wound for each stack. Okay. Desolation. The warrior deals an additional 3 plus damage to enemies that have no allies in adjacent cells. And then good old thick skin. The charge distance seems good, but I did specifically just say that I wouldn't go through them all. You know what, we're going to hit with the... let's go contempt. Let's just do that fat damage. Because he's going to be my main tank getting into melee. So I think that's just a safe thing to do. Obviously, I imagine if anyone does actually watch this video, they'll be screaming at the screen right now. But I'm sorry, I'm an idiot. Dismantling attack. The operative immediately inflicts 1 exploit on all enemies in combat and then makes a free attack against the target. That attack always hits. Okay, that's good. Until the end of combat, the target of this attack suffers a 30% penalty to jaws and 30% penalty to armor.
That's very strong.
Right. So we got some... I imagine we'll have the some psychic shit as well for her. Yeah. And that's going to be down at the bottom. Right, we'll do the top ones first. And then we will see. Tide of Excellence. Whenever an operative triggers an exploit on an enemy, the operative gains 1 plus damage, 1 plus armor penetration. Cool. Weak body, weak soul. Exposed weakness also reduces enemy toughness and willpower. Pretty good. Whenever an operative attacks an enemy at full wounds, they deal more damage to that enemy. Okay, instant exposure. Exposed weakness costs 0 AP. That's quite good. But then, those are all of the... those are more or less the operative part of her power. And considering that she is a predominantly psychic person, I think I feel like having a look at these would be worthwhile.
I keep yawning, sorry.
Unnatural luck. The power uses divination, psychic power, and on ally without an unnatural luck defect. An ally gains unnatural luck. When the ally suffers a critical hit, it becomes a normal hit. Okay. Every time a psychic deals mental damage from any source of other than aftershock, the target suffers half as much mental damage. Okay. Mental breach. Enemies that have taken damage from a psychic at least once suffer a minus penalty to all resistance attacks against that psychic. Enemies that have failed willpower resistance, and we got enemies that become target of any effect, suffer intelligence and perception. Pain channel. Whenever a psychic kills an enemy with a psychic power, dealing more damage than the target's wounds, the excess will be dealt to the closer. That's cool. I like that one. Enemies that become targets for psychic power gain a stacking minus penalty to dodge and parry. I feel that syncs up well with the operative, because that's the one that also lowers their dodge and parry. So I feel like that would be very good. After every 6th use of psychic power, all enemies gain a stacking minus 5 penalty to all characteristics. Enemies suffering from blinded, stunned, immobilized, or prone take more damage. And she's got psi ratings. So I'm guessing that's going to be the big one. I'm going to go with... Well, it said the ones with pain channel. I'm actually going to go Visions of Doom. I don't know how much it's going to be good early, but I feel like, you know what, let's go with the damaging one because it's cool. The way that I'm like, okay, so this tactical reason, I'll go with this. I'm like, no, that's cool. Fuck it. Let's do it. Firearm Mastery, this is for Argenta. A soldier gains the ability to make an extra number of attacks equal to their weapon's rate of fire, minimum 2. Using the weapon attack that normally costs the least AP, these attacks do not spend AP. Until the end of the next turn, their attack against each new enemy automatically scores a critical hit. The soldier reloads the current weapon. That's nuts. Then we got the plus ones for the battle sister, which is reloading. First reload does not cost AP. Rack and Ruin, which is after the soldier deals damage to 3 different enemies, the soldier gains 10 plus 2 times ballistic bonus and more damage for the next. So that could be awesome for her, like, sort of spread ability where she just like guns people. Camaraderie, for each adjacent ally the soldier deals more damage. Unpredictable, soldier gains 3 plus agility. Critical hit chance is doubled against enemies from which a soldier is protected by cover at the moment of attack. Fired up whenever the soldier deals damage, their critical damage is so immediately. Let me just check to see whether there is specific battle sister stuff. Let's have a gander. They're going to be down here. She'll probably end up getting a flamer, I'm not going to lie. And it's scroll, scroll, scroll. And this is Imperial World characters gain. That's pretty strong. And then here are the Battle Sister stuff. Now, I don't know whether she just gets these later. I don't think she does. Litany of Purification. All enemies in the area effect of War Hymn or Furious Recital gain 1 plus stack of Disturbed effect. Okay, now how do I get Furious Recital? I'm guessing that comes later. Let's have a gander. Is that like the bard? The bard part of it. So until that comes up, there's no point getting that. I like the Rack and Ruin one. So she just blasts. She gets the bonus to ballistics from my ability. She gets the bonus when she kills 3 enemies. That's her like battle sister thing where she goes nuts and just kills everything. And then she gets that on top. So I think that's the way to go for this first one. Excelente. Let us progress. The Void Ship Bridge. Hell yeah, let's do this, boys. I'm sure nothing bad has happened to Edelfred. Oh no. Lore warp. The horrific vision is a product of the warp entities that permeate the bridge.
None shall
obviously
stand in
priority
my way.
Stealing.
The first sacrifice opens the eye.
Oh no, is this a Tzeentch thing?
The second sacrifice draws its gaze.
Shoot him! Edelfred, no! When a hero can save me, I'm not gonna stand here and wait. Edelfred looks somewhat harrowed, but is in still one piece. He glances you, then over your shoulder, clearly alarmed.
Burin, are you here? Where is the Lord Captain?
I feel like I should not tell him. She's dead.
The Lord Captain will not be joining us.
Edelfred gives a confused look, then as a realization dawned on him, his eyes filled in disbelief. Oh, shit.
No. The rogue trader is dead?
Edelfred shudders, grabs a soldier, and as you watch, the sleeve of his jacket burst open, and 2 bone growths pierce through the fabric.
No matter what ritual comrade is performing here, the warp is too strong. I cannot withstand it. I feel my body changing with every second. The warp ringing in the air. This is the end. We will perish in the warp, along with the warrant and all the dynasty's heirs.
The enemy of humanity has triumphed.
Idira looks anxiously at Edelfrad and then she glances back to you.
I've seen it before. We'd better get away from him. The changes are already accelerating.
Said, I forbid you the very thought of yield. Only to resign your fate, you truly self-defeat. The ship can be steered out to warp as for, so perhaps the warp does not have to be the end.
The ship could still be steered out of the warp, but we must find and restore communication between the bridge and this navigator sanctum.
Edelfrad stares at you and his eyes harden with cold resolve.
Then we have no right to bow our heads.
Yeah, my boy.
He might be turning into hideous goop, but he's still my boy. Are we just going to let him do this? You can see Cumrag Voigtgeir clearly in the gloom of the bridge. The broken blade he is holding is stained with dark drops that seem to have a pearlescent glimmer to them.
We are out of time.
Edelfrad bites his knuckle desperately, thinking you see a wave ripple across the whites of his eyes and then turn a sickly yellow. I think I just bang him out here. I'm going to go for the lead here. I could talk to Edelfrad, draw a weapon, or to the party.
Ready your weapons. If we are to die this day, let us die with honour.
No, Boren. To die together is to allow the fray of the dynasty to perish in the dark. No, it would not be like this. Not today.
Edelfrad lowers his head, then he sighs and locks eyes with you, his gaze cold, haughty, and fanatical.
The ritual will not be completed. I'll take care of it, and you see to it that the void ship breaks free from the warp. Watch over our realm, and farewell.
No!
Accursed traitor, a time will come when you bleed to have a Lady Theodora's murder. Remember my words, for they are the vow of he who marches towards his death.
What? Theodora is dead?
Voigtgeir stares at you in seemingly genuine bewilderment.
No, that can't be. Not now, I still haven't.
Hell yeah, nerd.
Your ritual won't be finished, heretic!
Oh, never mind. Yeah, beat his ass. Uh-oh. Oh, no.
But he's still good. He's fine. No, he's alright.
Called heroic act or desperate moments, momentum is required. High momentum values allow you to use a heroic act. See, I wondered what that meant when I was doing the level up. So now I'm happy to learn. Right, Argenta into cover. Idira, come with me. And Edelfrad, get ready to lead the attack. So I'm going to keep you out of cover here. Oh no, it's half cover. I'll take that. Right, I'm up. Various enemies and I can look at them. Okay, cool. So I'm going to slightly sit on... Oh no, I can mark the target here. Cool. So I can shoot at this chaos spawn. Did I miss?
Fuck!
Oh no, it cast it. I shot at him. Okay, cool. Now I'm going to go over here. Voice of command. Argenta, my queen. And I'm going to hit her with that. And that will bring her up in the movement order to where she can... I need to hit everyone. Alright, we're just going to use a normal shot to begin with on the cutthroat. Get ready. And grants momentum. Oh, so those second abilities that we just unlocked... I was wondering what they were good. They're the mastery ones. Alright, I'm going to sit on that just for a second. Sit on that, and now she's got her proper go. To which I'm going to run and gun. I'm going to pull up... No, I'm just going to shoot. And I'm going to pop... Okay, I can't actually do it now. Alright, slight fuck up.
That is not the Emperor's will.
Yes, it is. I am his servant.
I will not.
I got no line of sight on the spawn. Move here. And let's go for... If I can hit all of them with that...
Each strike is a prayer.
Oh, she's too good. And let's switch straight away. Expose weakness. Or analyze enemy. No line of sight. Brilliant. I don't want to expose her because she's just too squishy. Decisions. Let's go straight with a psychic yowl. Just sit on that expose weakness and just wait. But I will hit me with the foresight. Now, I need to be careful about growing that little demon bar. The purple one, that's... Okay, that's not good. Right, Abelard. Let's do this. You're up. Hell yeah. Brace for impact. Strike this abominable demon. I mean, sorry, Edelfrad. And then let's do the endure. I think I have to open the turn if I'm going to use the special. Oh, no problem. You just eat it.
Mmm! Damn! That shit good!
So I want to see if I can slip my way through to get to those enemies. Because I don't want them just to continually unload as we're trying to kill. Now, how do I use my special ability? Can I just give him an absolute monster of a... Yeah, let's just open up. Well, we're sending him back to Commissar School. Alright, Abelard, you're getting the boost. And he's getting the bring it down as well. If I can. I can't. Never mind. Right. Sister. Dear sister. Now this will be the third enemy she's killed.
As the Emperor commands, I act.
So that should now give her the ability to do her mad nun shit. Hell yeah. I'm going to save that until I've got a next turn on it. Now I hit him with exposed weakness. That. Exposed weakness. That. And I don't want to use her zap because I'm worried she's going to... Yeah, I'm going to total her. No, I'm just gonna keep her there. Let's play it safe. Oh, shit. Now, is that a status effect on the ground? I feel like it is. Alright. So this is the part of the fight where I just continually wail on him. Oh, I can eat... Alright, I definitely need to kill the... I've killed most of them. There's only one left. If I can slip Argenta past, that would be swell. Unless I can sort of shift him around the outside, which I can't.
Victory is imminent.
Hit point buff. That's good. Cutthroat, I feel like he's not long for this world anyway. But I'd rather just be able to kill him now, but I don't think I can. I don't know if the ground is, whether it's just the characters that have been marked as poisoned, or... I'm going to play it safe. Move it here. Voice of command. On Argenta.
I don't have time for this.
I'm going to give Abelard an extra turn. And he's just going to absolutely paste this guy. I don't know if I can get to the that other soldier. So I might just force him to eat him and then just burst him down following that. So I'm going to give him... I don't want to hit him. Alright, step forward. We're taking this man to Commissar School. I'm yet to have my chain axe, which greatly saddens me, but you know what you're gonna do. Now we activate Big Dick Mode. And we activate Run and Gun. Now if I can actually get around here... Hell yeah. I'm just gonna take it, I'm just gonna eat that. I'm gonna shoot this guy. Absolutely lay him out. Never mind. I'm gonna commit to laying him out.
As the Emperor commands, I act.
Fuck. Oh, I see. I'm understanding how the heroic acts work now. Let's... Can I do a screech?
Anything is.
He's probably going to eat that guy now. Yeah, there you go. Right, now we just swing. Yeah, you're not hitting shit, my friend. Oh, no, he is hitting shit. Now, I could do with giving her a medipack. So I'm actually going to be a good teammate here.
Let's patch you up.
Look at him go. I'm in contact, so I can't exactly give him the big swing. Or give him the charge, I should say. But now we just got to burst this dude down. And I am, to do this, I feel like my big damage dealer is Eberlard right now. Considering that I gave him the ability to hit harder when after he's been hit. I think that's working out pretty well. A voice of command. Who's not got it?
All too easy.
Give the bonus to Argenta. And swing. Yeah. And Argenta's going to take a step.
I will bathe this battlefield in righteous fury.
Let's just take a half cover. Hopefully she can reach and not shoot anyone. Reload. Typical. Is that going to hit anyone? No. Nice. Hits the target.
Can I fall back now?
Right, let's get let's just get her out of the goo zone. Let's stick another one of these on.
Was that you? Or...
And then... Let's use all of those stacks that we got. So he's about to get laid out now. Alright. Yeah, you swing at Eberlard. He doesn't care.
My ears are ringing.
Now this is the enthralling part of the fight where I just beat the shit out of this guy. Willpower, which is like temporary XP. I'm going to stab this dude. With that. And I'm going to give another turn to Eberlard, who is going to swing. Oh yeah. Voice of command. Does someone not have it? Eberlard doesn't. Cool. Alright, you're back up, Queen. Let's give you Run and Gun for that extra, so I can just have that second turn. Now, I believe I've got Voice of Command on her right now, which would suggest that she's getting the bonus to overexerted. Oh, okay, what's that do? Oh, okay, right. So I can use... Right. So there is a...
I'll do it.
there is a slight cooldown on that. Stick some stuff on him again. And let's go for the psychic screech.
Anything else?
There you go. Now this should be it.
It's nothing.
He shouldn't take us to another turn.
I've suffered worse.
Yeah, he's tanking that shit. He's not. He's had worse. Oh, we're turning the big dick money on now. Does it fall to me to bollocks the final strike? Surprisingly, no. We must find the Master Helmsman, who probably has been stabbed. We've leveled up again. But this is the end of the episode, so who knows what I'll make a mistake on next. I just looked at the time and it's another hour and I went over because I was too enthralled in the battle. I hope you've had fun. And I'll see you next time. Bye.